Pisgah Science, and this is more on My Meeting John Pertwee. So, in the one of the videos that I just finished doing, the one with the my DVD collections, I mentioned when we got to the demons that I had met John Pertwee, and so somebody asked me to give more information about that. So that kind of led to this video. It kind of all started. I sent a letter to the PBS station sometime in 1983. Now, keep in mind, in 1983 I was 11 years old. So I wrote a letter to the PBS station, and they actually gave me an address for Tom Baker, for his London management representatives, his agent. And so I actually wrote to Tom Baker, and he sent me, or they did, I'm probably sure he didn't send it to me, but he sent me this photo and this signature. Now, I've done some online searches, and I don't know that it's his signature. The K looks a little different than the way he normally signs it in other pictures that I've seen that he signed. So I'm not sure if this is authentic or not, because I didn't actually see this. This was sent from that agency, and I'll post that letter, or I may have already posted it for you to see. So it's from a lady named Laura Lee Rochester, who at the time was public information director at the Mississippi TV station. And I have the letter here. That's what I'm looking at. I actually saved the letter from 1983 that I received from them. And she actually mentions here in the letter, "I hope you'll be watching ETV on November the 23rd at 8 p.m., the day before Thanksgiving, because there will be a special Doctor Who program called The Five Doctors. It is an anniversary special celebrating 20 years of Doctor Who on television. As you know, the title of the show comes from the fact that five different actors have portrayed the Doctor in various series history." And so, believe it or not, over the next probably 5 years, I continued to write back and forth to Mississippi ETV and exchanged information. I did a school project on Doctor Who. I might do a video on that one day because it's really funny. I did it as a junior high project on Doctor Who. So that takes us to December the 6th, 1987. In 87, I would have been a sophomore in high school, I believe. December of 87, yeah, I would have been a sophomore in high school, and I'll put a picture here that I took inside this van. Now, keep in mind, this has been a long time ago for me, so I'm trying to remember as best I can. I will tell you that the public broadcasting station, the headquarters in Mississippi, is in Jackson, which is in the state capital, and I live about 3 hours away from the state capital, so somehow I convinced my father to drive me 3 hours to go to this get-together. I expected there to be a lot of people there, and there really wasn't a lot of people there. And I'm not sure what December the 6th was, but he drove me those 3 hours, and I remember seeing Bessie. Bessie was there, and we actually could look inside. Of course, it was roped off, but you could see inside it. And then they took us to this big trailer, which is where the entrance is, where the picture that you'll see. They had kind of a mock-up TARDIS, kind of a corner of it. It wasn't the whole console or anything. And then you walked through this trailer, and you saw some costumes. Now, we weren't allowed to take photos on the inside at all. And I'm sorry to say that my memory is so bad, I can't remember what I saw on the inside. And I really have no memory of what was inside. You'd think that would be something that would stick with you, but for some reason I can't think of what it could have been on the inside. I want to say there was a Sea Devil mask, but I don't remember that for sure. And I want to say there was a Dalek in there, but I don't remember that either, for sure. And so anyway, then we went to this auditorium where we heard John Pertwee speak. And the story that he told was about the Carnival of Monsters and the ship that they filmed on in the Carnival of Monsters. They said they could take anything, and of course he took the spare compass. And if you've ever seen John Pertwee talk, he tells this story almost everywhere he goes, or the people around him tell this story. I think I've heard the Brigadier, Nicholas Courtney, tell this story online on YouTube before. So he told that story, and he told a bunch of other things about it, and then basically all of us that were there, and I don't remember how crowded it was. I mean, I was really shy. I was a sophomore in high school, but I do remember us lining up and me actually getting to the table where he was. Incredibly nice guy. And of course, you may think, I would have thought he would be disappointed because I don't remember there being a lot of people there. Less than 50, I would think, because Mississippi's not that populated, but Anyway, I do remember us getting in line and me getting to the front of the table, and he asked me what my name was, and I told him Wesley. And so yeah, this is what he gave to me, and I'll put a picture of this up as well. But it says to Wesley at the top, and it says John Pertwee, Doc number 3, and 87 at the bottom. He asked me what my favorite episode was, and I think I mentioned it before, and I said The Demons. And at the time, you could only see The Demons in black and white. As a matter of fact, I had never seen it in color until it was released on DVD. I'd always seen it in black and white. And I think black and white actually does it better. It makes it even more creepy, I think, when it's in black and white. But he also mentioned that that was one of his favorite stories, and he knew that it was only available in black and white, and he said that, you know, he wished we could see it in color. And he thanked me for watching, and I was moved on in the line for the next person to get their photograph. I don't have any other memories of that, and I don't remember what happened afterwards. I don't remember what happened on the way to this trip. I don't remember what happened coming from this trip. I have very little memory about this event, and you think, as important as Doctor Who is to me, that I have some sort of better, clear image of that day, or you think I'd never forget that day. But it was amazing to meet the man. I have a much greater appreciation for it now than I did then. Like I said, in 87, I was a sophomore, so that'd put me at like 16-ish? 15, 16, something like that. Yeah, I think I'd have been 15. Or about to be 15. I don't remember. So anyway, I just wanted to share my memory of the special day that I actually got to meet John Pertwee. Being in the United States, and from Mississippi, which is where I'm originally from, I lived there for 40 years of my life. So I haven't been to any conventions or had a chance to meet any of the other actors, and I don't know why they came to Jackson, Mississippi, and I'm so proud that he did. So I haven't met anyone else from the program. However, I did get retweeted by, I did get a tweet from Katie Manning, which, you know, made my day as well. So that's kind of the new meeting a celebrity kind of thing. So anyway, that's my story, as much detail as I can remember. I wish I had more detail to give. I wish, you know, part of getting old, I wish there was more memory up here to give. But that's all I have. Thanks for watching.